While Iceland's brand new volcanic eruption is now over, it left behind something underground that can in the future put a new area at risk. That April 1st, non-April Fool's actual volcanic eruption began at approximately 39 kilometers or 24.2 miles southwest of the nation's capital city, Reykjavik. While this eruption was spectacular, it was also unusually and suspiciously short-lived. Only lasting for 5 hours, only 700,000 cubic meters of lava was emplaced across an area of a mere 0.24 square kilometers. However, there might be a reason why this eruption was so brief and had such a low volume despite initially having a potential supply that outsized any of its 7 prior eruptions since the volcano reactivated in 2023. While I had previously proposed that this all came down to only low volatile and low gas magma remaining in its shallow magma chamber, I would like to suggest an alternative explanation. As, for the first time since November 10th of 2023, the magma dike that had acted as a figurative highway for all of these recent eruptions to occur above greatly expanded. In fact, based on the substantial earthquake activity this expansion caused, it appears that it enlarged from 16.1 to 24.3 kilometers in length, jumping in size by 50.9%. While we don't truly know what depth this dike expansion occurred at, 5 kilometers or 3.1 miles depth seems like a good fit given the present data. The timing of when this expansion happened is also quite telling. Lava effusion ended just before 1:30 p.m. on April 1st, but the beginning of rapid dike expansion began around 1 hour later. This potentially suggests that magma which could have otherwise erupted at the April 1st fissures was instead redirected away from Grindavik and sent into new areas below ground. While this is purely speculative, I'd like to think that at least 60 million to 75 million cubic meters of molten rock was involved in this dike expansion. This magma dike seemingly ceased its forward northeast motion around 7:30 p.m. on April 1st, with no new activity since then. Of course, whether the magma dike actually did reach this far is up for debate as we need ground deformation data to arrive still, but for now, let's just assume that what I have mapped is correct. Since surface volcanic eruptions can occur literally anywhere above where this magma dike exists, while unlikely, a future volcanic eruption could now occur away from Grindavik north of the summit flat Reis mountain that comprises the Fagradalsfjall volcano. Before I state what specific locations this expansion could put at risk, I want to note that magma has for the most part only actually erupted about where the intersection between an east-northeast trending pathway and the northeast trending dike intersect. This is why 6 of the prior 8 eruptions had a surface fissure active in this very intersection. And magma becomes progressively less likely to erupt at a point further and further away from said intersection, taking more energy to reach there. The furthest surface eruptive fissure from this intersection that formed since 2023 at the Reykjanes volcano was 4,602 meters away. Yet, to have the potential to create a problem in one of the following outlined highly unlikely scenarios, magma would need to travel nearly double this distance at a minimum and then erupt, quite an unlikely possibility. Lava erupted from any such point on the expanded dike would initially travel northwest, north, or north-northeast, meaning that any point on this overall peninsula could be affected by an advancing lava flow. This means one or more of several dozen structures in addition to the 1,300 population town of Vogar. What I am trying to say is that these areas no longer are at what was essentially a zero volcanic hazard and are now in a very, very low hazard area. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Sudhokar Chandurkar, for supporting my work.